Good afternoon, Panthers. I'm Ananya Reddy.
And I'm Mason Myers. Welcome to another edition of Claw News. In today's podcast, we'll be taking a look back at a lot of events, such as our Advanced Band Winter Concert, our choir concert, and looking back at another episode of Paw and Order.
In the last broadcast, the 8th graders got a show of their skills on the court. So later on, the 7th graders will get the spotlight.
Until then, let's talk about one of the biggest events that happened at PHMS just a couple weeks ago, the Winter Dance.
On December 2nd, Pioneer Heritage hosted our very first dance of the 2022-2023 school year, the Winter Dance. This year's theme for the Winter Dance was Pajama Party, hosted by our amazing PHMS cheer team. There were decorations, games, foods, prizes, and so much more that our amazing cheer team put together. Many of our students went to the dance and had a lot of fun. Let's go see how it went and get an insight of what people thought of this amazing event.
Freeze! Everybody clap your hands! Come on, y'all! Check it out, y'all!
The party, and I mean it was winter dance, but it was like a party. Many people was having fun, and I liked the game, and I really think it was, yeah, I really liked it.
This dance was one to remember, and a pajama party sounds like a blast. Thank you to our PHMS cheer team for hosting this event, along with our amazing cheer coaches and parent chaperones for making this dance a big success. Once again, a big thank you to our PHMS cheer team, cheer coaches, and parents who worked so hard to put this event together.
There are so many people who work hard in and out of PHMS, and a lot of which are our PHMS tennis players.
Let's see how they did in one of their recent matches.
Hey Panthers, it's Maggie and Emily Conti, and right now I'm at Reedy, where we face off against the Clark Cougars. I'm going to play a match later tonight, and I'm really excited. It looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. Let's go check it out.
I'm here with Hasini Pawar, one of our advanced tennis students. What was your favorite part about today's match?
The tennis match was really fun to play, and we ended up winning.
Well, it sounds like you and your team had a lot of fun. Congratulations on your victory.
I'm here with Coach Dodd. So how have your players been practicing to prepare for this match, and how do you think it's helping them?
We've been working a lot on doubles play and double strategy to get ready for a really competitive opponent. And then we've been working on consistency to keep the ball in play because a lot of their strength is in singles. And we want to make sure that we make them earn every single point they're going to win against us.
Well, it certainly seems like they're using some well-practiced techniques here.
That was an amazing match. We had some really close games, but our Panthers pulled through and got the win against Clark. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. I'm Maggie and Emily Conti.
Great job, Panthers. You guys did amazing. I could tell that you were working hard.
Our tennis players aren't the only people who are shining stars in our school. I'm talking about one person in particular who has really been making a big impact at our school.
Miss Emerson is one of our assistant principals here at Pioneer. She joined our community just this year, and she's already connected with so many of the students and staff here at PHMS. She works tirelessly to put events together for us and always does it with a smile. Let's talk to some students and teachers to get a better sense of just how great Miss Emerson is.
I like Miss Emerson because she cares about her students and always makes sure that we're safe.
I think Miss Emerson is a really, really great like teacher because she always cares about people and she's really, really, really funny at lunch.
Hi, Miss Emerson. I'm not spoiled. Thank you for always being nice. You're my favorite assistant principal, and you've been the best assistant principal at the school. And
I like Miss Emerson because she cares about her students and is grateful for her students.
Hi, Miss Emerson.
Hi, Miss Emerson.
It's really fun at lunch to see you, and you always tell me to sit down when I'm always standing.
Thanks for being so nice to us all the time. Me and my friends are alone too. I love you, bestie.
From all of us at Pioneer, thank you so much, Miss Emerson, for truly making an amazing impact on our school.
Miss Emerson is an amazing assistant principal and is kind and friendly to anyone she meets.
Speaking of staff members who work hard for our school resource officer, Jonathan Verghese, has been working really hard to put on something special for our PHMS 6th graders.
That's right. It's that time of year for It's Party Time.
Hey Panthers, it's Ashpapana and I'm here at It's Party Time. Today, Officer Verghese is talking with our 6th graders about the importance of drug safety. Let's go see how it's going. I'm here with Annie Roberts and Caden Emery. What have you learned about drug safety today?
Like marijuana can like mess you up. Or like anything can mess you up.
Basically, when you're under the influence of alcohol, you can't like even tell like where you're walking or which way you're going. So it's really bad for driving and it can be embarrassing.
Yeah, drugs definitely have a lot of side effects and can be really dangerous. I'm here with Officer Verghese. Do you think it's important for kids to know about drug safety?
Yeah, I believe it's critical for children to understand the importance of how drugs can affect their systems and so forth. At this age, kids in school feel the peer pressure and all sorts of things to start using narcotics and get introduced around this time. And so I think it's important to be taught the effects of narcotics, of various narcotics on the street and how it can affect them.
Yeah, it's definitely important, and I'm glad we are teaching this to our 6th graders. Well, Panthers, our 6th graders have learned a lot and are definitely going to be more cautious in the future. That's it for It's Party Time. Thank you for watching. I'm Sasha Popana.
I think it's very important to learn about the dangers of alcohol and drug use. Plus, this is a really fun way to learn about it.
Thank you so much, Officer Verghese, for putting this all together.
Let's talk about some more events at Pioneer.
Like our advanced band concert. Let's see how it went.
Low Panthers, we are at Reedy today to watch our band students perform at the winter concert. Everyone is filing into the auditorium, getting ready, and from what I can hear, it sounds really exciting. Let's go see how it's going to go. Panthers, I am here with Nikila V and Max W. How do you think the performance went? Are there some things you could improve on?
I think the performance went pretty good. I think we could improve in the beginning because we slowed down a lot.
It went great overall, but we had a lot of mistakes in practice, but I'm surprised we didn't have as many in the concert.
You guys did great. Well, Panthers, from what I saw, it was a very engaging performance. Everyone was super happy to see their child and their peers playing, and it was a very cathartic experience. I hope to see more next time. Thank you for watching. I'm Shushita Gutta.
That was an amazing concert.
I can tell you guys were working really hard.
Hard workers are everywhere at Pioneer, and one of the hardest workers at our school is our school resource officer, Mr. Varghese.
This is his first time hosting Paw and Order, so let's see how it goes.
Panther Nation, it's Officer Varghese bringing you this episode of Paw and Order. And in this episode, I'd like to turn your attention to the recent uptick of school threats that we've been facing nationwide, but particularly here at FISD, and how your partnership is important to save your life and the lives of others. I just want to say this is applicable to all students, your parents, teachers, administration, doesn't matter. So in law enforcement, we've been experiencing or noticing students creating these troll accounts and posting these threats on social media with hopes of staying anonymous, but more importantly to bring a lack of ease and discomfort in a school or learning environment. Remember, threats can be spoken, they can be gestured, they can be written, and threats can be expressed as a direct threat or an indirect threat, and they can be explicit or implied. So just know that threats rarely involve gun violence or explosive devices. So if you say you're going to hurt, you're going to attack or conduct illegal activity, it can be taken as a threat. So what are your next steps? Number one is notify an adult. Notify someone at school, it's a teacher or administrator. You can come find me. But the one thing I do want to touch on is an anonymous way of doing of reporting these things. It's called the Stop It app. Frisco ISD uses the Stop It app as an anonymous reporting tool. They use it so students can feel safe and confident in reporting these sorts of threats or behaviors or illegal activities conducted at school and that bring a concern to the school. So for further information regarding Stop It, just visit the Frisco ISD website. You can search Stop It, it's one as one word, and learn how to download it to your device, whether it's an Android or an Apple device, it doesn't matter, and you can begin reporting these kinds of behaviors anonymously and confidently.
For his first time hosting Paw and Order, I think he did a great job.
Paw and Order is one of my favorite segments, but another favorite segment of mine is watching all the performances that occur at Pioneer Heritage.
Another student who continues to work hard every day and represents our core values will be featured in this edition of Student Showcase.
Pioneer Heritage is centered around showing pride, positivity, respect, integrity, dedication, and excellence. For this edition of Student Showcase, this student represented these core values in both in and out of the classroom. She is oriented ready to give her best whenever she arrives in class. According to the teacher who nominated her, she said this. She, quote, seeks clarification when she is uncertain and is a great all-around student. She challenges herself to always improve, and this shows in her work. She works well with everybody and is friendly. She always wears a smile. When she is absent, she takes initiative to ensure all her work is turned in and completed, demonstrating several of our core values. Our nominated student truly chose an exceptional demonstration of our core values and works tremendously hard to continue doing her best. Now, you may be wondering who this student is. Here's the plot twist. She's on the Claw News team. Now, drumroll please. Shristita Gutta has been nominated for this edition of Student Showcase. Congratulations. Now, let's go see what Mr. Jodger, the teacher who nominated this student, and a few of Shristi's friends think of her passion and the drive for her to grow.
I think Shristi is an amazing student. She comes to class every day ready to learn. She's always got a smile on her face. She advocates for herself as well and is not afraid to ask questions. Shristi is a model student in GT and outside our classroom as well. I hear nothing but great things about her from other teachers, and she really just has a desire to always be at her best. She definitely exemplifies all of our core values here at PHMS.
Shristi is a great friend. She's really smart, and she's always there for me. She's a really great friend. I'm really happy she got the award, and she really deserves it. She always helps me with anything that I need, and I'm really grateful that she got this award.
I think Shristi is an absolutely amazing person. She's a great friend. She's really smart, and she works really hard in class, and I think that she really deserves this, and it's an honor to be her friend.
Once again, congratulations. You truly do exhibit our PHMS core values, but you also work hard to always learn, grow, and be an amazing student both in and out of the classroom, and you are an amazing friend. Thank you for showing positivity, respect, integrity, dedication, and excellence.
I'm in a few of Shristi's classes, and I can tell you firsthand that she is one of the kindest people you will ever meet.
Great job, Shristi. You really deserve this recognition.
There are so many amazing students that we want to recognize, and we haven't taken a look at any of our 7th grade athletes yet.
Let's see how they did at their basketball games.
Hey Panthers, I'm Kayla Knowledge, and I'm here at the 7th grade girls basketball game. They're playing the Scoggins Seahawks. C team started out with a tough first half. Let's see if they can make a comeback. Let's go see how they play. Shiloh and Pranavi, what do you think your team could work on?
I definitely think we'd work on passing, being more aggressive, and just communicating and shooting more baskets.
And what do you think your team did good?
We were like way more aggressive than last time. Last time we were like, okay, you can take the ball, but this time I think we like tried more harder to stop the ball.
You guys did a great job. It's never easy watching our fellow Panthers suffer a tough loss, but we are proud of them for how hard they worked. Let's go see how B team plays. I'm here with Zoe, Sanika, and Harper. How do y'all think the game went?
I think it went great. It was very intense and we were really close, but overall we did pretty good.
Like you said, we only lost by a couple points. There were definitely some points in the game where we didn't really know who was going to win. I think our defense was pretty good, definitely an improvement from our last two games.
I think we did really well. We got some great defense and good rebounds, too.
I totally agree with y'all. Y'all did really great, and it was really fun. It was a really fun game to watch. Layla, how do you think the team did?
I think we did really good. Our shots, we made a lot of our shots. I feel like we moved really well. I feel like our communication could be a little bit better, but other than that, we won, so.
It was a great night full of ups and downs, and every team worked hard. Thanks for watching, I'm Caitlin Arledge.
This is Tommy Jengama, and I'm out here at PHMS, where our 7th grade basketball team plays against the Scoggins Seahawks. Let's go see how it goes. I'm here with Alex Baker. So Alex, how do you think you did in today's game?
I feel like I did pretty good. We had a good team effort, but we just couldn't finish it off at the end.
I'm here with Noah and Sahas. So can y'all tell me how you feel about this game, how you think you did, and what's something you can improve on for next time?
Well, I think the game went okay.
I think the game like went okay, but we played good in the first three quarters. In the last quarter, we could have done better rebounding. But we also could have not fouled a lot. We keep fouling a lot, and on like when they're pressing us on full court, we have to learn to get the ball up instead of dribbling right in front of them.
Also, we have to start learning to when somebody gets the ball, we have to stop dribbling and we have to just look up and see who's open and pass to them.
I'm here with Jack, Luke, and Hayden. So, what was your best place?
I think one of our best moments was whenever Hayden hit a three in somebody's face.
I think it was when we were breaking the press and we had a fast break layup that we missed because foul.
I also think it was my three.
I'm here with Aiden, Cole, and Jackson. So y'all, how do you think your game went?
I think it went pretty good. We've been practicing hard and we finally got the outcome we wanted.
We did really good. We finally won. Feels nice. We did really good. We worked really hard for this and I'm proud of it.
Although B and C team lost, A team won. The games were incredible to watch and we're so proud of all of our Panthers. I'm Tanvi Jinagama. See you next time.
I can tell you guys did amazing and tried your hardest out on the court.
I think that's something everyone's noticed is that a couple weeks ago everyone was carrying around flower babies.
What are flower babies?
Every year, our Skills for Independent Living class does an assignment that gets them ready for parenthood. Flower babies. We've been doing flower babies for quite some time, and it's a lot of responsibility, but it's also a lot of fun. But why do we make flower babies? Let's talk to some of our Skills for Independent Living students and Ms. Stedman, our Skills for Living teacher, to find out some more information about flower babies and why everyone likes them so much.
I liked Flower Baby Unit because it was really fun and it gave me sort of a feel of how taking care of a real baby would be. I loved carrying it around, and at first it was heavy, but I got used to it, and it was fun to dress it up in little outfits, and I loved how today we got to do some of the simple things that we need to do to take care of a baby daily. It was really fun, and I really liked it.
My favorite part of the flower babies is, like, it gives me a perspective of how to actually take a baby, and it's so cute. And I loved all the photos I took today, and I just thought it was so cute. And I got a little diaper as well. And yeah, it was a little annoying at first because it was kind of heavy, but it was really fun throughout.
Well, we do our flower baby or flower sugar babies unit every year to help students learn about how children develop, specifically as infants, 0 to 12 months. This is one of their favorite projects the whole year. And as I'm sure the whole school has seen, they carry their flower babies around the school for 5 days, which is part of this project, to care for them for 5 days.
Flower babies seem like a lot of fun, and I can tell that everyone enjoys them. And the best thing is after the week is over, you get to make food using the flower. This is definitely a great way to get students prepared for adulthood.
It looks like we're nearing the end of our broadcast. Before we leave, we have a ton of new paw print articles out, and our student Q&A for this broadcast is, if a genie could give you any wish, what would it be?
And we have a new topic for our podcast. It's called Expectations and Self-Worth. Make sure to check out our TikTok compilation because we have a lot of fun videos that we make just for you.
Well, Panthers, that's a wrap for this edition of Claw News. Thank you for joining us. I'm Ananya Reddy.
And I'm Mason Myers.
Panther Nation, Panther Pride.
The Clark Cougars. I'm about to play a match. No.
I'm with Prachi Seshadri. Okay.
Tough first half, but... I know. That's why I'm mad. C team started off with a... Well, game.
We're at PHM. And being more aggressive in a game.
Hey, Panthers. You, I should have to stop saying that, because in post-production, it's going to be like, hey, Panthers. Ready? I'm Jenna Gummit, and I'm out here at PHMS, where our 7th grade players play against. Hey, Panthers, it's Tommy Jenna Gummit, and I'm out here at PHMS, where our 7th grade...
I'm here with Officer Varghese. Do you think it's important to teach kids about the safety of using drugs?
Absolutely.
About drug safety.
Absolutely. I think it's critical to understand the importance of using drugs and... Oh, that's not what I was supposed to say.
6th graders have learned a lot and are definitely going to be more cautious in the future. That's it for its party time. And then they, okay.
Understand what drugs are on the street and the narcotics and how the implications...